Hello there, it's Ben Bowers, the Spirit Specialist, and festive greetings to you, even though at the time that this is going to be released is a little bit early. I am here today to talk to you about the new Snow Globe Christmas Gin Liqueur, the 2022 edition. If you saw any of the videos from the previous couple of years, or if you did get your hands on one of those, you'll notice that the package is quite drastically changed from the last 2 years. We've got a nice little handle on it. We've got a different shaped box, which actually kind of is a little bit awkward to kind of pull out and put the bottle back in and everything like that. But as with the previous couple of years, I'm not going to do that because it gets awkward to put it back in because of the flaps. So let me take the other bottle, press the bottom of it. There we go. It lights up. We've got the gold flakes still inside, but slightly differently this year is the liquid that's inside it. Whereas the previous 2 years were orange and gingerbread, this particular edition is now spiced orange and cranberry. So the orange and gingerbread for the last couple of years was light, it was delicate. You may well have seen the video where I compared it with the Marks and Spencer's edition and also the really not particularly and quite possibly illegal Aldi version as well. But they've done a bit of a switch up in terms of the flavour profiles. Interestingly, which Marks and Spencer's haven't done. Marks and Spencer's have kept theirs exactly the same. Same bottle, same flavours, all this lot. Switched things up slightly this year, improved packaging, different picture on the bottle, that sort of thing, and a different flavour profile. So what I'm going to do is give you a little idea. I'm not going to give you some background information in terms of like the history of Gravity Drinks who make this, because I don't think it's really that interesting. But what I'm going to give you an idea is what it tastes like on its own. But also, I've now come up with a cocktail that involves this, that's incredibly easy to make, looks really good, feels incredibly festive, that will absolutely A, use this bottle up, so you need to buy another one from me, but also give you a lovely festive cocktail, dead easy to make, that you can use with your friends and your family and really have a good time in what is proving to be another very difficult year. So, the Snow Globe Gin Liqueur, they call it the Christmas Globe, which I think is the official title. I've got no gold flake. Oh, maybe one gold flake in there. I obviously didn't shake it up a little bit. It is worth kind of giving it a little bit of a shake before you pour it, just so that the gold flakes don't just sit on the bottom. I'll tell you what, I'll turn the light on while I try it so you can see it in all its glory. And let me just give you a quick idea of what we're looking at in terms of flavor-wise. So on the nose, cranberry right up front, really nice and fresh, not overly sweet. There is a definite juicy cranberry note on the nose, and then a little touch of spice in the background, and there is that sort of Christmassy spice feel. So I'm getting a little bit of nutmeg in there, nutmeg more than cinnamon, definitely. There's a definite nutmeg feel to it, as well as juicy cranberries. Not so much of the orange. Maybe there, maybe like orange peel rather than kind of like fresh orange and cranberries. The cranberries put potentially kind of like just dominating the orange element in there because it is a sharper fruit note. But a really nice nose, really refreshing, but there and obvious, but light and delicate at the same time. And that follows through onto the palate. As with the previous snow globes, it's not particularly sickly. The base spirit that they're using, and I know all of these ones are called gin liqueurs, but if you saw the video with the Aldi, the problem with that one was it was almost like the base spirit was really acrid and they were having to overload all the sweeteners to kind of mask that flavor. The base spirit is very neutral in terms of flavor, and it very much is cranberry, nutmeg in particular. Again, as what's on the nose is very much on the palate, but the orange starts to come through more on the finish. It's not hugely complex. It's not massively full of flavors, but the flavors that it says on the front of the label are there, which means that this is incredibly approachable for literally everybody. It's not sickly, it's not sweet, it's light, it's delicate. It's very, very easy to drink. Some people might argue too easy to drink, but this is a gin liqueur in a snow globe that's Christmassy, like all of the other ones. It's still way more complex than the Marks and Spencers and the Aldi and every other snow globe-y, Christmassy type gin liqueur that I've come across. it's easily the best one out there, just in terms of the flavor profile that's there, that will still approach everybody and everybody will enjoy it. So again, they've not done anything particularly too drastic. I do like that cranberry note that's coming through. It makes it fresher. You've got a little bit of spice there, so you still get that sort of Christmassy vibe in there, but that red berry note works really, really well. Now, what I am gonna do is now make you, and this is a twist on a French 75. So a French 75 is traditionally gin, simple syrup, and lemon juice, and then you shake that up, you put that in the bottom of a champagne flute, or you can stir it up if you want as well, and then just top it up with champagne. So I have a little bottle of fizz. Everything's in the fridge, right? I am not going to be using ice for this. You could, if you wanted, do the second stage of the dry shake with ice if you wanted, and I'll explain it there. But let me go and get, because I've got my wireless mic, let me go and get the stuff out the fridge so I've kept it cold. Now, like I say, you could use ice if you really wanted to, but I want to try and make this as easy as possible for absolutely everybody. So I have a little bottle of Prosecco, and that is all we need. Four ingredients on this. I've got the jigger already with the cocktail shaker. So what we have here is, I've got a mini bottle of Prosecco just for the purposes of this. And you can basically use whatever you want, because you're going to be adding flavors to it. So it doesn't have to be, you know, Veuve Clicquot or anything particularly fancy like that, unless you want it to go really fancy. You just want sort of, you know, a half decent Prosecco. I also have cranberry juice. Now, unfortunately, the Co-op were out of Ocean Spray, which is what I really wanted to use. So I've got Co-op's own cranberry juice drink. This is not fresh cranberry juice, and ideally, I'd be wanting to use fresh cranberry juice. So this is not the ideal Festive 75, but at least it will give you the idea of how to do it. And I also have Giffard egg white. Now, this is pretty key, because you could make this with simple syrup and you would get a fairly nice fruity cocktail. But if you add an egg white to this, you will also get a lovely creamy feel texture to the cocktail itself, and also a really good foam on it. Now, you could use simple syrup, sugar syrup, and then just add an egg white to it. But that's messy. You've got to prat around with an egg. This stuff, game changer for sours and things like that, because this is simple syrup and egg white in one go. So this will give you that frothiness, and that will get accentuated once you add the Prosecco in one fell swoop. So I have my cocktail shaker here, and I am going to, now it's not ideal doing this sitting down, but I can't find an angle where I can get the camera and I can stand up and a bit of space around. So I'm gonna do the egg white syrup first, and I'm gonna do just under 25 mils of that, because I want more of the egg white influence and less of the sugar syrup, because the globe itself is pretty sweet already. Now, this is getting quite messy. I have a bit of, let's go for slightly over 25. This is where I start pouring it down my trousers. So that's not 25. I'm just gonna go for a little bit more, because I want a bit more. I'm not going for a full 30. This is a 15, and this is not 25, 50. This is a 15 and a 30. So I've got about 15 mil of sugar syrup in here. And then I've got about 25, 30 mil of cranberry. And then I'm gonna go for pretty much the same. I'm gonna go for 30 mil of the liqueur. Now, surprisingly, I've not actually chucked this all over my trousers, which is good. And I didn't get any in there, so I'm gonna give it a shake and see if I can get, because I didn't get any gold flakes in there. There we go, there's some gold flakes going in. That's better. Bit of gold flakes in there. So let's say half a part of egg white syrup, one part cranberry, two parts snow globe. Or if you wanted, equal parts cranberry and snow globe. So what I'm now gonna do is shake this up. Now, dry shaking technique, which is good for when you're using things like egg whites, is shake it without ice, and you get the foaminess, you get that aeration through the egg white. Whether you're using egg white or egg white syrup, you'll get aeration coming through without ice cubes basically knocking it back down. But what you then want to do is get it chilled as well. So a dry shake technique is you shake it without ice first, then add ice, shake it again, to then chill that drink. Now, I've kept everything in the fridge, and I can feel it in the shaker. It's still cold. So I'm hoping that it's gonna stay cold, and then I've had the Prosecco in the fridge as well, so that's gonna keep everything cold. If you wanted to add the ice, after you've done this initial shake, fair enough, that's not a problem at all, but it's not a necessity. And what I've also found is that if you just do a dry shake and don't do the second part of it, rather than if you've got one of these pouring it out the top so you're losing some of that froth, take the whole of the lid off and just pour it straight into your glass. So I've given it a decent shake, and if you want to do all of this lot, feel free in front of your friends. I'm going to take the lid off, and you're not going to be able to see in there, possibly, without tipping it up. No, because I'll just pour it on the floor. There is a good froth on top of this, and you'll see that as you pour this. So if I pour that in there, actually, the froth isn't there. It might, you might want to spoon a little bit out of it. But what you're then going to do is, you can see there's a little bit of froth already in there, is as you pour your Prosecco, or your fizz, or your champagne, or whatever you want to do, the bubbles in that will actually increase the foaminess of it. Now, don't do what I did. Ugh, 2 seconds. Right, so I've just had a delivery driver turn up. So I'm gonna reshake it. I've poured it back in the glass and give it another shake. I've just poured some down my knee because this is not a great cocktail shaker. This is just a cheap one that I use, but I still have a frothiness in there. So let me pour that back in the glass just to kind of rejig it a bit, and not brilliant, but it's obviously warmed up very slightly. So nice pink color on there. And actually you get a bit more of a head on there than we did on the last one. Now the Prosecco. So don't do as I've done the first time I made this and pour it from a height, because you're already gonna get foaminess from there. So if you just do that, you're already getting a fair amount of froth straight off the bat. So in terms of pouring the fizz, you actually wanna do it pretty gently if you can, because your head on it is gonna get accentuated. And I can see a little bit of gold flake. I don't know if you'll be able to pick that up. You won't, because I don't wanna tip it on the floor, but there's a little bit of gold flake in that fizz. So just pouring it as gently as, you know, as, not even as gently as that, you get a really big head on it. You get a nice pinky tinge on there, and that is cheap co-op cranberry juice concentrate drink. This is gonna be even brighter if you're using like a proper cranberry drink. So good froth on it. The froth itself feels creamy, thick almost. And then bubbles, sweetness, cranberry, there's gin in there, there's gold flakes in there. It's so Christmassy. It looks nice just like that, and it will look even brighter. Put some, you know, up your quantity of cranberry juice and you'll get even more of a pinky tinge on it. So it looks really festive. And that is what I call the festive 75, as opposed to a French 75. It's a little bit sweeter. It's not quite as zingy as a French 75, but let's face it, in Christmas times, Christmassy times, people want sweeter drinks, that sort of thing. And with fizz as well, it's absolutely ideal. So, Merry Christmas. I know it's a bit early at the time you may be watching this, but that is one way of making a dead easy Christmassy cocktail for you, your friends, and your family, provided they're over 18, obviously, of the Snow Globe Spiced Orange and Cranberry. Hang on, yes, Spiced Orange and Cranberry Gin Liqueur. It's not lit up anymore, so let's do that. Let's turn it back on because it does look really pretty and festive, and because this has been in the fridge, it's slightly, but there you go, there's all the gold flakes running around. 23 carats. I don't know what's happened to the other carrot, because normally most places are 24, but this is jolly, jolly tasty. So that's me done. Merry Christmas, everybody. I hope you have a safe and peaceful festive season, and I shall see you at the next video. Cheers.